We are multisensory creatures. We see the world, we hear the sounds, we smell the smells. So it only makes sense to combine inputs or modalities. And your AI PC chatbot can already combine text and visual understanding. So when you ask the chatbot what the content of the image, you can see that it understands that there's a stop sign, a car, and so on. And my NPU is working using the NPU acceleration library. Running this LMM, large multimodal, is very easy. Just jump to the end of this video. It's few lines of code. But how does it work? Attention is all you need, because when processing natural language, a key factor is to understand the relations between the words. The dog is barking in the street. Who is barking? Where is it barking? And so on. Words relate to each other, and these relations allow us to understand the sentence. The cross-attention mechanism at the heart of the transformer's architecture basically identifies these relationships and allows the model to understand the sentence. And we already have a great architecture called transformer to execute it. Encoder on the left, which maps the inputs and understand their relationship. And decoder that can process the relationships and generate the output. And this is a text encoder. Take the input prompt, break it to tokens, convert to embedding, use the encoder. All set. Probably the most compute-hungry operation in the transformer architecture is the cross-attention mechanism. Let's assume that we want to use the same architecture to process images. How can we create cross-attention for images? Should we code the relationships between any pixel in the image to any other pixel? That sounds impossible, even for small images. Well, we cannot do it for every pixel, but we can do it for clusters of pixels, for patches. So we can crop the image into patches, then convert each patch to a vector. Now we have vectors that still hold the pixel information, but we lost their positional information, and that is very important in an image, in the same manner, or even stronger, than in a sentence. So we can add the patch position to create the embedding, and we have embeddings, image embeddings. And now, if we process the output of the encoder using a multi-layer perceptron MLP head, we can train that system for various tasks like image classification, or we could use this encoder to encode images and the text encoder to encode text and train a model to match them. This is CLIP, contrastive language image pre-training. If we add this CLIP vision encoder to a fine-tuned LLM, we get Llava, large language and vision assistant, a combination of a language model that can understand what you're looking for and the CLIP vision encoder to understand the image. I'll be following this blog, link also below. Installation is simple. Make sure you have the latest NPU driver. Open a virtual environment, activate it, install the NPU acceleration library. It will basically bring over everything you need for execution. Few examples here. Make sure you have transformers, torch, and pillow, and you are all set. There are multiple ways to program the NPU. Check out my videos on programming the NPU using WebNN or using OpenVINO. Here, I'll be using the NPU acceleration library. The NPU acceleration library is a simple, lightweight way to get started deploying to the NPU. It's integrated with PyTorch and transformers, and it's been developed and improved every week. The code is simple, Hugging Face, few lines of code. Get the libraries, pay attention to the Intel NPU acceleration library. This is our model, Llava Gemma 2 billion, and on line 10, compile it to the NPU. This is an alternative to Torch compile. If you're using Linux, just use Torch compile and model backend is NPU. The next lines, just put the inputs in order. We use a template for the text and then combine the image, both now in inputs, and inference generate the output and print it. Running the script is not that exciting. First run will bring the model, which takes time. First inference also takes time to load the model. The second inference will be much faster. And it is working really nice. And you can build a simple script to interact with the user to get a new prompt or a new image. And that's all. Your AI PC can run large multimodal and process text and images. Try it out. Subscribe. Thank you.